Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about congenital talipes equinovarus. It is abbreviated as CTEV. It is also known as clubfoot. Congenital talipes equinovarus or clubfoot is a congenital fixed deformity of foot. This picture shows an infant with clubfoot. As you can see, the feet are rotated inwards and downwards. Now let us see about the clinical features of this condition. As the name indicates, there is equinus and varus. Equinus is plantar flexion. This picture shows equinus deformity. Varus is inversion and axial internal rotation of subtalar joint. As you can see in this picture, there is inversion and axial internal rotation of subtalar joint. This is varus deformity. There is also medial subluxation of talonavicular and calcaneocuboid joints, which is known as adductus deformity. This picture shows adductus deformity. It occurs in 1 in 1000 births. Male infants are more prone for clubfoot. It has a polygenic inheritance pattern. It is bilateral in 50% of cases. It is associated with a decrease in calf circumference, which is related to muscle fibrosis. Now let us see about the diagnosis of clubfoot. It can be diagnosed prenatally with ultrasound. In infants, x-rays are unnecessary because foot bones have not yet ossified in them. When a child presents in walking age, we can take x-rays, and in x-rays, the talocalcaneal angle is reduced, both in AP view and lateral view. Now let us see about the differential diagnosis of clubfoot. Myotonic muscular dystrophy, poliomyelitis, cerebral palsy, metatarsus adductus, and spinal deformities with neurological sequelae are the various differential diagnosis of clubfoot. Examples for spinal deformities neurologic sequelae include spina bifida and myelomeningocele. They can be ruled out by observing for caudal dimpling, hairy patches, or other associated findings. Now let us see about the treatment of clubfoot. Serial manipulation and casting is the treatment of choice. Casting should begin immediately after birth to take advantage of the initial elasticity of contracted ligaments. Initially, casts are molded to correct cavus deformity. Then we have to correct forefoot adduction and heel varus. After this, we have to correct equinus deformity. This is known as Ponseti technique. If casting is unsuccessful after 12 weeks, we have to do operative correction. There can be mild recurrence, so we have to advise parents that fully corrected foot will have some residual stiffness, calf size will remain small, and the foot will be smaller than contralateral foot. This picture shows club foot in the course of correction. This picture shows a foot adduction brace, namely Dennis Brown bar brace. This is useful in patients after correction of clubfoot. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. For more such videos, please check out my playlists. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe. Your subscription will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.